Good morning! It's breakfast time, the best time of the day. Are you going to help me this morning?
Like every morning.
I know. This is my trusty sous chef, and we're going to make breakfast.
And that's not S-U-E chef, it's S-O-U-X.
That's right, I don't sue him. So, I'm going to... we're going to make... What?
Okay, that's fine.
Did I say something wrong?
Well, the Sue I was spelling was Sue the girl Sue.
Okay, cup and a half of water in there.
I guess they're the same.
Huh? Good water. We're gonna have steel oats, and we're going to make some kale. We've already got some kale that's chopped up with some onions, and I'm gonna saute that in the pan. And today I want to teach how important protein is. Protein is super ignored during breakfast. I mean, like a normal breakfast. We get up, we have a bowl of cereal, we have a glass of orange juice, we have toast.
The we is not written.
We don't. The world, the standard American diet. Cereal, toast, milk, juice.
Standard American diet. S-A-D.
Sad, sad, sad. We're going to show you that protein is one of the most important things that you can eat for your breakfast because it keeps you full, it makes your blood sugar not go sky high. You haven't eaten all night and then you throw all that sugar in, you're in trouble. And guess what? You're hungry a minute later. So, protein's important. I even have a new batch of fermented cabbage with onions and garlic in it that I'm very excited to start eating for our good belly. It's very important that we have a large variety of vegetables and fruit with our meal. So as you can see, I've got onions and squash and kale. So the more color that you use, the more variety that you use, the better the vitamins and minerals that you're getting in your body that it needs. We'll add an orange to it today, and we already had our little shot glass of blackberry juice, 100%, which is great antioxidant. Pomegranate juice also is a great antioxidant, so we'll just take a little in the morning to be able to not get too much sugar. It was all natural, but still too much sugar, and still be able to get the nutrients that we need for our probiotic. And the steel oats is done. We'll just put a lid on that. We got these nifty little egg thingies, vaginis.
Holders.
Put those over to that side. And we're going to cook these right in this deep grease. It'll be really fun. That fire as low as it can go. Look at that one, Jim. You want to break yours?
Right an egg.
He does it one-handed. Wow. Look at you, Mr. Perfection. Your egg broke right on cue, all by itself. Push these all over to the side. Add some quinoa. Quinoa is a very, very good protein. It's the only plant that is has all the essential amino acids in it that your body needs. Mostly it's animals, animal proteins that give you all of the nutrients. Milk with cream on the top.
We made more than we normally make on this cereal.
Two bowls of steel oats. So if you think that you do not have time to eat a protein diet, then make it the night before or have things in there. If you have to use your microwave, use your microwave. We try not to use our microwave. We never had a microwave until we moved here because we'd gotten rid of it. But, you know, do your eggs. Boil some eggs the night before. Have a dozen eggs in your refrigerator at all times so you can just pull out an egg and take it on the run with you, along with a sliced up apple and a bag of carrots. That's a breakfast, because you've got vegetable and fruit and a protein. I already told them. Well, maybe I didn't. Who knows? Maybe it wasn't on.
This is our cabbage that we have fermented. Just a small amount, a little bit of help each day with the additional probiotics. That was probiotics.
And I just put the vegetables right down on one side of it. And I like to put my egg up over it so that it melts right on the top and oozes down with my bacon. Got our bacon all equal now. Everything is turned off. Breakfast is served.